What's up, Lore Masters? This is an addendum to my last video discussing shuttles and that of the warp drive. It's always interesting to me when people respond in a fandom. I know that I've made mistakes in the past of varying degrees, from the absurd to little-known logic that only a few would know, but for the most part, I really do try to do my research and attempt to improve when I mess up. So when people respond so pompously, like something is so well-known, and it's not, it's even contentious, it makes me chuckle. I also find it curious when people expect me to be a channel like that of Trek Yards or Space Dock. It shows a fundamental lack of understanding of the channel itself. While I do try to be a quote-unquote lore master and knowledgeable, this channel is ultimately a discussion, not the word of God. I'm a knowledgeable fan on this stuff, so with that out of the way, let's just get into it. In the latest video, as I discussed, quite a few people stated that they believed that the warp core was more an energy source and didn't create the warp bubble. That the warp core was a matter-antimatter reactor that just generated the power for the nacelles that created the actual bubble itself. Additionally, some attempted to say the fact that the Romulans appeared to utilize warp drive and that their ships were powered by singularities was proof of how you don't need a warp core. First, I'm not convinced that we can use the Romulans as an example. As we discussed in my breakdown of the Starfleet comm badge, the words that we hear are for our benefit and that of the Starfleet officers. It may not be reflective of what the technology actually is. As an example, it is unlikely that the Romulan Star Empire and Klingon Empire utilize the same warp scale and call their weapons the exact same thing. These words are translated into common concepts that Starfleet would understand and may not reflect the actual weapon or tool or speed. Do Romulan ships utilize warp drives as we understand them? Maybe. Certainly the configuration would lead one to believe that, given that the ships do have nacelles. Also, the alliance with the Klingon Empire in the original series may also have led to the development of warp technology, so there is that. However, we honestly can't be sure. So to say definitively would be, in my opinion, premature. Taking a look at the Dedera Dex, which is the only ship confirmed to use the singularity, you'll notice that it doesn't have any impulse drives. Now, some will note that the reason for this is that they were never finished on the model itself, but Alpha Canon means that the impulse drives are either not viewable, or the Dedera Dex is using technology we haven't seen before. It is also possible that the singularity allows the ship to move at impulse in a way that we don't understand. If this is true, then perhaps it also works different when it comes to warp capabilities. And there is another example, using the Romulans, that really kind of solidifies why I even brought up that I doubt it could be a fusion reactor. I refer to, of course, the episode Balance of Terror, where one of the key plot points is Scotty stating that the Romulan vessel they are fighting has simple impulse power. The Enterprise, which could go to warp, was faster than the Romulan vessel itself. Now, this is a hotly debated topic that we'll be staying out of, but what Scotty was getting at was that the ship utilized fusion reactors and could only go at impulse. At least that's what he believed. So it could not keep up with them via warp. If the ship had warp or not is debatable, and again, I don't really want to get into it. I'm just pointing out that the Romulan vessel did use fusion reactors and it only had simple impulse power. Speed was the Enterprise's best bet. Regardless of Romulan technology, however, I've seen convincing arguments and watched a few clips that do lead me to believe that the warp bubble is generated solely by the nacelles and not a combination of the nacelles and dilithium. And this really makes me consider working on my phrasing when I do videos, because I never really meant to infer that the nacelles didn't play a critical role. I was just saying that the dilithium had to be combined with the nacelles in tandem. And again, I was wrong in this. It would seem that the more I look at it, dilithium is used as a power source only, not critical to the bubble. Which, I know, shocking that I was wrong. As I stated, apparently this channel can't just be dialogue in a conversation. I have to be your god of lore, so... And if you put master after your name, it means you can't be wrong, like, ever. But ultimately, that doesn't answer the question. The question does remain. Most Starfleet shuttles can enter into warp, but there's no visible warp core. So, do they use fusion power, or do they utilize a warp core? Well, further research shows that they do utilize warp cores, and how do I know? Well, most of this is brought from the series Voyager. In Voyager, several different types of shuttles eject their warp cores in order to either stop an event or to not be killed by a warp core breach. Which we never see happen in any other series when it comes to shuttles. So I guess they make Voyager shuttles out of the parts from a Galaxy-class ship.
Now, Lore, you were wrong about the warp cores, so let's not make this worse by going ahead and insulting Voyager fans, okay? I think we need to take your smart alecky card away for today.
Ugh, Fine, I apologize. Voyager is the awesomes. I won't make any more jokes for this video. When it comes to fusion power being enough to power the nacelles, again, a little skeptical, but it's not really that big of a deal to me. So if it is, it is. If it's not, great. As I stated, I'm not tied one way or the other. It's just an interesting conversation. One thing I do love about this is that when we talk about one topic, like shuttles, it can spur a completely different conversation, like that of how warp drive is attained. And that is one thing I love about this fandom. But those are just my thoughts. What are yours? Let me know in the comments below. As always, guys, remember that in the end, our lives are just stories. Make yours a good one.